And actually, if we take this prayer combined with the message that Holy Spirit gave me, let's see, was it the day before? Yep, the 27th. We can see that Holy Spirit is teaching me to be spiritually responsible by not being responsible in the world, by surrendering that sense of responsibility. We can see that this prayer is helping with this. This prayer is, first of all, not at all in denial. This prayer is admitting that I believe in the world, that my mind is split, that I am attached to the world, and that I think my salvation is here. You know, getting things done right, making money, all of that stuff in the world. So it's admitting to what I believe. And then it's asking for help. It's acknowledging that I need help. It's giving my willingness and my trust. And it's asking for guidance. It's admitting that I don't have a clue and that I need guidance. And then it's surrendering. I am in your hands. So it's a great prayer that Holy Spirit gave me, a tool that Holy Spirit gave me to follow up on his request from the day before, that I let go of being responsible Regina, which is actually what people used to call me. once again, I'll let go of the mic and see if anybody has anything they want to share.
Sounds very familiar. I was dependent on Carolyn.
Zoe, yes, Zoe, please take the mic.
So, hi, how are you? Miss you guys. Anyway, my question is, Regina, how does that project into the projection? I mean, you're still responsible because you show up here when you're supposed to show up. I know you make sure that Jasmine is fed. Explain more about how that works. Okay, thanks.
First of all, I got to tell you that when you said you're still responsible, you show up here when you're supposed to, you make sure Jasmine is fed, Jasmine goes, huh? And she did have to get her own dinner tonight.
Well, I am sorry.
We seem to have nights. We seem to have nights where we sit down and eat as a family, and we seem to have nights where it's everybody grab your own. And tonight was an everybody grab your own night, so. but yeah, I can talk about that, Zoe. The answer is much more of a mind shift than anything else. When Holy Spirit was asking me to let go of being responsible Regina, he was not at the same time asking me to now become a couch potato. He wasn't doing that. It wasn't about form as much it was about who I saw as responsible. I'll use that for lack of better words right now. Did I see myself as responsible, or did I see Holy Spirit as responsible, and I was just willing to follow prompts? You might say, do I see myself as the leader of getting things done, or do I see myself as a follower in the process of getting things done? And what happened is Holy Spirit is teaching me to really be responsible in a different way, to be responsible by not seeing myself as the leader, as the one who is responsible for getting things done, but seeing myself as the follower. So what that means is the guidance as to what to do comes from something else. And in this case, what we're really talking about is it doesn't come from the thinking, planning mind, and some sense of personal responsibility. That's what's being let go of, the thinking, planning mind, and some sense of personal responsibility. And when that is let go, there is still a prompting as to what to do. And then, instead of being the responsible leader, I am still the responsible follower, so I follow the prompts. So in a way, I am still responsible, but it's taking myself out of the role of being the one that is personally responsible for getting things done and moving into the follower role. And also, when you move into the follower role, you're a lot more accepting of things as they are because you no longer feel personally responsible. It is funny, Zoe, back when I was responsible, Regina, I would not have had nights where I said to the people in my house, okay, we're not having a family dinner tonight. Everyone just grab your own. Because out of guilt, I would have felt like I had to prepare that family dinner. The fact that I had other things to do, you know, that I was being guided to do other things, that would not have mattered. I would have killed myself. I would have been super Regina and probably super bitch, too. Oops, I said another bad word. But it's true, and you guys know it's true. Trying to get it all done. And I'm sorry, Jasmine.
Are you the Regina I know you are? People, she never says these things.
I don't. But it was a perfect word to describe what you guys know. Okay, give me a kiss. Let me go back to teaching. Okay?
Yeah. Bad word!
I haven't said the B word in a few years, but it seemed very appropriate. Because that's what I would have been. I would have been driving myself crazy trying to push myself to be responsible and get it all done. I don't feel responsible to get it all done anymore. I only feel responsible to do what I'm feeling guided to do. So it's very easy for me to say, hey, I'm not cooking tonight, guys. You're on your own. Okay, Zoe, please take the mic.
Regina, do you think that because of the personality that, you know, that is you, that you were able to discipline yourself to let go the same way you disciplined yourself to do everything? I'm thinking that that's what question that comes in my mind. And oh, tell Jasmine when I come to visit that she's going to have to wear earplugs. Bye.
I don't know. Okay, now Jasmine wants to know when you're coming to visit. And what she means is she says bad words. So you have to wear earplugs.
I have a music player, you know, I can...
Yeah, she says she has an MP3 player. She can just wear that. And now she's ready for you to come, Zoe, so it looks like you're on your way. But yeah, no, I do think it's funny. Everything is very funny. I do think the fact that my personality was responsible was very helpful to me. Because when Holy Spirit asks me to do something, I am responsible and I do it. And to be honest, not everyone has that same ingrained responsibility. So lots of people will hear Holy Spirit's recommendation and not follow through. And the follow through is critical. And because I am able to follow through, when Holy Spirit says, make this decision, and I make it, Holy Spirit says, do this, and I do it, it's very, very helpful. So yeah, it's kind of funny. So again, letting go of a sense of responsibility does not mean becoming a couch potato. It means letting go of that personal sense of responsibility and instead shifting it so that I become more of the responsible follower than the responsible leader. But definitely the sense of responsibility and the sense of self-discipline is still helpful.